Hello and welcome to Folger Encores. He's Derek Jacobi.
And he's Richard Clifford.
And we're pleased to speak with you. The Folger has been sharing selections from their plays, music, talks, and readings with you in this Encore series.
And this week we're highlighting The Fairy Queen, a production with music that we both appeared in.
And I directed.
Alongside our dear friend, Lynn Redgrave.
The composer, Henry Purcell, and writer, William Shakespeare, are a natural combination for performance. If Shakespeare is the greatest English poet and playwright, then Purcell has a plausible claim of being the greatest English composer.
Of course, Shakespeare would never have heard Purcell's 1692 composition, The Fairy Queen, which was the music composed for the restoration version of A Midsummer Night's Dream.
The result, The Fairy Queen, has proved to be enormously appealing to audiences ever since its rediscovery in 1901.
We love being on the stage of the Folger and hope that you will enjoy hearing this selection from The Fairy Queen.
Please be sure to join us again for these weekly episodes of Encores, highlighting all that the Folger has to offer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Generally, man by man, according to the script.
Here is a scroll of every man's name which is thought fit through all Athens to play in our interlude before the Duke and Duchess on his wedding day at night.
Yeah, first, good Peter Quint, say what the play treats on. Then read the names of the actors and so grow to a point.
Marry, our play is the most lamentable comedy and most cruel death of Pyramus and his...
Oh, a very good piece of work, I assure you, and a merry. Now, good Peter Quince, call forth your actors by the scroll. Hey, masters, spread yourselves.
Answer as I call you. Nick Bottom, the Weaver.
Ready! Name what part I am for, and proceed.
You, Nick Bottom, were set down for Pyramus.
What is Pyramus? A lover? Or a tyrant?
A lover that kills himself most gallant for love.
Oh, that will ask some tears in the true performing of it. Or if I do it, let the audience look to their eyes. I will move storms. Yet my chief humour is for a tyrant. I could play Hercules rarely, or a part to tear a cat in, or make all split. The raging rocks and shivering shocks shall break the locks of prison gates, and Phoebus' car shall shine from far and make and mar the foolish fate. Now, this was lofty.
Yes.
This was Hercules. This was a tyrant's vein. See, a lover is more condoling. Now, name the rest of the players.
Francis Flute the Bellomender.
Oh, here, Peter Quince.
Flute, you must take Thisbe on you.
What is Thisbe? A wandering knight?
It is the Lady Pyramus must love.
Nay, faith, let me not play a woman. I have a beard coming.
Oh, that's all one. You shall play it in a mask, and you may speak as small as you will.
If I may hide my face, let me play Thisbe too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice.
Thisbe! Thisbe!
Oh, Pyramus, my lover dear, thy Thisbe dear and me dear.
No, no, you must pay Pyramus, and Flute, you Thisbe.
Oh, well, proceed.
Robin Starveling, the tailor, you must play Thisbe's mother. Tom Stout, the tinker, you Pyramus' father.
Me, Thisbe's father.
Snat, the joiner. You, the lion's part. You may do it extempore, for it is nothing but roaring.
Let me play the lion, too. I will roar that I will do any man's good heart to hear me. I will roar that I will make the Duke say, "Let him roar again!" "Let him roar again!"
And you should do it terribly. You would fright the Duchess and the ladies, and they would shriek. And that would enough to hang us all.
That would hang us, every mother's son.
Yeah, I grant you, friends. If you should fright the ladies out of their wits, they would have no more discretion but to hang us. But I will aggravate my voice so that I shall roar you as gently as any sucking dove. I will roar you as 'twere any nightingale.
You can play no part but Pyramus. Oh. For Pyramus is a sweet-faced man, a proper man as one shall see in a summer's day, a most gentleman like man.
Therefore, you must needs make Pyramus. Well, I will undertake it. Hey, what beard would I best to play it in?
Why, what you will.
Well, I will discharge it in either your straw-coloured beard, your orange tawny beard, your purpling grain beard, or your French crown colour beard. Ooh, your perfect yellow.
Some of your French crowns have no hair at all. And then you will play barefaced. But masters, here are your parts. And I am to entreat you, to request you, to desire you to con them by tomorrow night and meet me in the palace wood a mile without the town by moonlight. There we will rehearse. I pray you, fail me not.
Oh, we will meet, and there we may rehearse most obscenely. And courageously. Take pains. Be perfect. Adieu.
Oh, at the Duke's oak we meet.
Enough! Hold or cut bowstrings.